Hello and welcome back, everybody, to Clannad. So, last episode, I probably made the worst decision in my gaming history by not accepting Nagisa's invitation. I still feel a bit bad about that. And I hope she isn't all that much hurt. And I also feel like we kind of fucked up with Nagisa. But we'll see. Maybe it was the right decision. I doubt it, though. The bottom of the hill. Yeah, at least she's still there. We're not totally fucked up. Furukawa's there again, standing still as can be. Morning.
Hi. Ohayou gozaimasu.
What are you doing here again?
Matteta desu. Okazaki-san wo.
You were waiting?
Hai. Kore kara wa maiasa issho ni ikou to omoimashite.
That's also a way to get him to school on time. Huh? The school is right there, you know. You just have to climb this hill, that's all. She glances at the school gates. Climbing this hill. I guess it's something she still needs to work up courage to do. I feel she's more attached to you than you think. She looks back at me, holding down her hair as it dances in the wind. If you wait for me, you'll be late for school every day, you know. You should just go on your own, with or without me. It's not like I mind, though. Ah, I guess even a guy like me is able to help her. Funny. It almost feels a bit like luxury to be in this position. That's why I start walking. Let's go.
Hi.
Her feet pitter-patter behind me. Don't you need to figure out what you'll be having for lunch today? I see. In that case, let's go buy lunch together. You're just going to buy bread anyway, right? A little later, I'd look back and realize this was another odd promise I made to her.
Okazaki-kun.
Yeah. With nothing in particular to do, I had just decided to lie down on my desk when Fujibayashi comes to talk to me. Oh, worksheets. Are these from homeroom? Thanks. I reach my hand out to get the worksheets from Fujibayashi, but otherwise stay slumped over. In one fell swoop, I grab the worksheets and cram them into my desk. Do you need something else? I gently sit upright and turn to face Fujibayashi. Your sister is no joke, you know. Yeah, she was late today, wasn't she? I met her on my way here. She was on a bike. No. I just felt like something hit my head. Whatever. Anyway, this morning I was hit in the back by Kyou with a Is she standing behind him? Or is he having seriously psychological problems that every time he says something bad about Kyou that something hits him in the head?
Okazaki-kun?
Yeah, sorry, with a b- With a b- With a b-
Oi, Okazaki no yatsu, bai rashii ze.
Suge na. Otou ka yo.
What is that? Yeah. This is only politically correct in Japan. Alright, assholes, let's settle this in the restroom. Okay, that is the perfect answer though. That is the perfect answer.
Okazaki-kun.
Wait, Fujibayashi. This is a terrible misunderstanding. What I was trying to say was, Kyou hit me with a slap. All of a sudden, there is a small, quick thud on my forehead. Something came flying at me. It didn't really hurt, but I could feel the sharp impact ringing within my ears. Then it falls on my lap. It's an eraser. It seems the wider side got a clean hit on my forehead. It is also missing chunks. Were those tiny thuds I've been feeling pieces of this? Regardless. Who the hell is it? Well, who the hell is it? I wonder. As I stand up and yell, Kyou stomps into the classroom. She then mercilessly drags me out of the classroom by my necktie. What's the big idea? Huh? What else? That you ran me over with a bike? She covers my mouth with her hand. Huh? Why would I? As I raise my eyebrows, Kyou wraps her arm around my neck and drags me toward her. She then whispers to me in a soft voice so that only I can hear. Japanese schools are weird. Then don't ride here on something so dangerous. Even if you say something so selfish. And if I let it slip, you are awfully violent. Just how can this girl can say something so terrifying without a second thought? Fine. I let out a sigh and return to my classroom. Hey guys, actually, 3 is Kyou, Fujibayashi is bi. Okay, I gotta say, like, there are a few things I'm... You know, I'm not the biggest fan of the humor, the typical anime humor, you are run over with a bike, oh no, haha, if you tell somebody I'm going to put chopsticks up your fingernails and in your ass, and I don't know. But the comebacks are always pretty good. Actually, 3 East Kyou Fujibayashi is bi. Well, I think I did a pretty fine job covering that up. Well, if I didn't do that, I'd be the one who looked bad. Right, back at you. No joke? You're trying to tell me something? Alright. I click my tongue and return to the classroom. Sorry guys, I was just kidding. 3 is Kyou's Fujibayashi actually likes girls more than guys. Kyou pulls me away again. Jeez, what should I say then? That's so boring. Just talking to myself, don't worry about it. It's lunch break, but Sunohara still hasn't shown up. If he were here, turning him down would be a pain anyway. I got lucky. I leave the classroom by myself. I want to say she was in class B. I leave the classroom and look around the hallway. Furukawa is standing against the wall, so that she won't get in the way of traffic. Our eyes meet. Her face breaks into a smile as she trots over. About what? Oh, yeah. He's fine.
So desu ka. Yokatta desu.
Does she know about Sonohara? With that other person, he is fine. Yeah, she must be talking about Sonohara. Did she ever see him? I don't think so. Oh well. Sure. We start walking side by side. You know, walking around school with a girl is seriously embarrassing. What are you, 12? I casually look over at the profile of Furukawa as we stroll. Then again, I guess people would be jealous of me more than anything. Nothing. As always, the front of the bread line is crowded. It's so crowded, it's difficult to even approach the display case. Yeah. A single male student rushes past Furukawa and dives straight into the billowing crowd. He's quickly swallowed up and lost to the sea of bodies. The fuck? Nah, it's okay. I'll go buy something for you. Just tell me what you want and I'll get it. Come on. Go for something more exciting. I mean, you can buy one of those whenever you want. Pick something you can only get right now. Bring it on. She balls both of her hands into fists. What's that? That sounds weird. She's really emphasizing the point. Ah, never knew they sold anything like that. And again, I've never really been interested in sweet bread, so I guess I wouldn't know. Well, nevertheless, I'm heading out. Pray for my safe return. I give her a big thumbs up. Furukawa puts both of her hands together by her chest, theatrically. Okay. I wedge my body into a small space in the crowd. I then push forward by using my arms to shove any students blocking my path out of the way. As I'm doing this, I recognize the back of another student's hat. Sonohara. He didn't even come to class. Why is he here? I grab his shoulder. Hey! What are you doing here, man? Is there something going on today? It's not usually this crowded. I look to where Sonohara points and see an advertisement hanging from the ceiling. It says, new product, fillet of fish sandwich, 150 yen. I see. Now I get it. Do you really need to spread rumors about a sandwich? Not really, to be honest. Excuse me. Maybe someone wasn't just that good in English? Huh, he's right. Or maybe the fish is filled with something. Actually, I'm almost certain that it's just a misspelling. Sonora's shoulders are jerked down. He reaches out his hand, but I pull back to avoid it. Sorry, Sonohara. That was never how I saw it. So I guess that is his thing, getting dragged off dramatically so I can have my free time with Nagisa. Now, it's a bit deus ex machina, but on the other hand, it's the way it's made, it's funny, so I'll give it a pass. He swallowed up and lost to the sea. Can't be standing around either. It's only getting more crowded as time passes. The mass of people feels like it's about to burst. Are you all that desperate to get a piece of Miss Belt, Brett? I blindly charge forward. And then... I got it. In my hands are a piece of dual-colored bread and a sandwich for myself. Thanks for waiting. Yeah, I managed. Somehow. Yeah. Everyone must be so sick of studying that they're getting themselves worked up over a new piece of bread. We head to the courtyard for lunch. Our time there is quiet and peaceful. Almost like my days at school up until now. I wonder if we feel so at peace around each other because we're both outsiders. It would be mean to call her an outsider, though. I look to my side. She's intently eating her bread. She's so into it that it's funny. I assume this is how she always is, putting everything into whatever it is she's doing, even if that thing is simply eating lunch. She only ended up this way because of bad luck. I guess bad luck. Unlike me. Furukawa doesn't even notice me staring at her, as she continues to eat her bread, seemingly unaware to the world around her. After a bit, she folds up the bread's wrapping paper and puts it in her pocket. Even as she talks, I keep looking at her face, sort of lost in thought. Our eyes meet. Yeah? No, you're good. I mean, your eyes are gigantic, you know, it's hard to look. Okay. Hey, Furukawa. I think you're cute. Partly because of just who you are at your core, you know? How you carry yourself, your demeanor, that kind of thing. I think that once people get to know you, they'll all like you. I have zero doubt that you'll be able to make plenty of friends. No, this isn't me trying to cheer you up. I'm just sharing my thoughts, I guess. A first impression, let's say. Like, we've practically just met, right? So, you can take those words at face value. Take them at face value. I grab her shoulders and tell her, as if I'm giving instructions. You know, you are right. I quickly realize just how strange what I said actually is. I sit back down. As I do, I meet eyes with a female student in the third floor window of the school building, directly in front of me. Hey, try waving again. Smile while you do it, though. Like I told you, I'm a guy. If I just spontaneously waved by myself, they'd think I'm a creeper. I don't know, I doubt that. Oh, you're right. If I did that, I wouldn't be able to hang out with you anymore. Never mind then. Listen, you. You little... I poke her on the hat. Furukawa laughs. Actually, no. It's not quite a laugh. She went as far as smiling, but... I look in the same direction as her. I find myself looking at the third floor window of the school building again. The shadow has disappeared. Hey, Furukawa. Want to go to the club room? Furukawa stands up and brushes the dirt off her skirt. This damn music gets me every time. I'm always all emotional. Although this scene was actually really touching by itself. This scene would have been also pretty good without the music, but the music for the touching scenes between Nagisa and Tomoya it's so nice and soothing and romantic and all that. God damn it. How much time do we have?
ます。
Okay. Let's use that time to make a flyer that says the club is looking for members.
はい。
Furukawa nods vigorously, excitement building with each bob of her hat. The two of us start writing things down with magic markers on a piece of office paper. We need to start by choosing a date for an open house, and we can tell people more about the club then. We won't be able to get anyone in the doors if it's too soon. So how about 2 weeks from now? I can only hope things go that well. Don't you think it could use a little more... something? I think what's missing is... Sex appeal, a drawing, collaboration. Okie dokie. Lo safe. How about a drawing? Sex appeal. God damn it. It might sell some people on the drama club, but I'm not sure I want these people in the drama club. I think a drawing would be nice. Collaboration would probably not hurt as well, but you know, I like drawings on flyers. Or posters in this. So in that case, get a drawing, Furukawa. Who else is gonna do it? Had I not gotten an F in art, that may be a possibility. But I did, so it's not. Okay, then we should do something else. Yeah, I did. Me as well. Well, my teacher was never that mean. Hey, mine told me that the catcher mitt I was drawing looked really sturdy. I wonder which one of those is worse. Mine went out of his way to call it a catcher's mitt. Why that and not a regular baseball glove? That's what I want to know. Should I go get someone who's good at drawing? I stand up, tired of unproductive dispute we're having.
Huh?
Yeah, that would be the best. Ah, maybe that was a misjudgment. I sit back down. Furukawa asked me with markers in her hands. Think of something yourself. What are you good at drawing? Curry. She totally shut me down there. It must really be an awful memory for her. Sure, as long as it's cute. So a bunny, a cat. As soon as she finishes speaking, her hands begins moving as she hums the song. It's a melody I've heard somewhere before. I can't remember what it is, though. Curious, I take a look at what she's putting down. I see a small circle with a face on it. Just as she finishes drawing one, she draws more and more of the same thing. The club recruitment notice quickly finds itself occupied by strange creatures. She proudly shows me the flyer. The whole poster is practically covered in mysterious creatures. What are you? Some kind of idiot? Look, you can't even read the text. Why would you draw all these bizarre creatures on here? What are they? Oh, I finally get introduced to the whole Dango thing, huh? The big Dango family? It's the title of a song that became a huge hit a while back. I think it wasn't used in a kids' show. Oh, so that's what the melody she was humming just now was. Anyone in Japan would know the song.
Dango大家族は大家族なんです。だからたくさんいるんです。
Let me be straight up with you, Furukawa. You're really not cut out for this. The big Dango family. How long ago was that? It's already dead and forgotten. I'll admit that this might be cute, but it's out of fashion. You're really out of touch with what's popular, aren't you? Really? Well, I'm glad to hear it. Mans, I hate Tomoya. Did I mention that? How can he be so cruel at someone so defenseless? It's a riddle. It's I have no clue. I start to rub my temples. Yeah, I'm starting to rub my temples too. Looking at what she's come up with, we might be better off if I just drew my catcher's mitt. Any regular person who sees this is going to be repelled by it. It would be one thing if she drew this as a joke, but she's serious about it. Furukawa's spirits begin to plummet as she watches my reaction. This isn't good. I can't let her sink into an utter pit of despair. I have to do something. Well, I guess it's not bad. Yes, but that doesn't mean that the big Dango family isn't cut out for the drama club. This is starting to require some mental gymnastics. Me neither. She doesn't seem particularly sold on the idea, but I do seem to have salvaged the situation. As I stare at the flyer, I start to think that it actually shows what kind of person Furukawa, the club president, is. In that sense, maybe it's a lot better than a flyer adorned with lies. In any case, we're done making our notice. It's got some spice to it. All is well that ends well. After my strained attempt to wrap things up, I grab the piece of paper and stand. To the copier. Should make a bunch and go around putting them up after school. I think that's the most we could do today. After that, we use the copier in the teacher's room, then head home. I return to class to find Sunohara I return to class to find Sunohara with his face buried in the desk in front of him. It's probably because he wasn't able to buy whatever the new item on the lunch menu was. I decide to leave him be. Right decision. Sunohara is still dejected even after classes end, so I'll leave without him. I head to the drama club room. I didn't come here in any particular rush, but I don't see Furukawa. What is she doing? She does seem pretty slow. Maybe she's already putting up the posters. I wait, but she doesn't show. Bored, I scribble on the edge of the blackboard. Day duty, Nagisa Furukawa. I finish scribbling and wait a while longer, but she is still nowhere to be seen. Maybe something happened. I start to feel a little worried. Oh, that is actually a good question. I'd go look for her. I mean, it's totally possible that she will go into the drama club room and, you know, we'll miss each other. But, you know, just in case. She's hopeless. Don't tell me that she accidentally went to the class next door or something. I could see her doing that too. Yeah, but she would have realized. I don't think she's that stupid. Check somewhere else. Somewhere else? It could really only mean the courtyard. I look down from the window. She's there alone. What is she doing? Does she think it's lunch or something? I wouldn't put it past her. Sheesh. I climb down the stairs and head to the courtyard. She's sitting in our usual lunch spot. I approach her. Hey, you know it's not lunch break. What are you doing here? Furukawa's holding a bamboo broom. Spinning its handle around in her hand, she sits without a word. From the looks of it, she's down again. What's wrong? Did something happen? I sit next to her. Sand gets caught in the bamboo broom's tips as she continues spinning it in front of her feet. So it's your turn on class cleaning duty, eh?
Hi.
She finally answers. So, what's wrong? Why aren't you cleaning?
Stemashita.
You were? Were you? So why did you stop? She thinks for a bit. Then she quickly stands up. After saying that, she starts to walk off. Hey, hold on a second. I get up too and follow after her. I don't get you, you know that. You're now gonna treat me like a bad guy? You don't have to go so far as to call me a good person. But I'm not the kind of person who would harm you, right? I'm not too sure about that. You said some pretty mean things to her. Then you can just tell me what's wrong, like you always do. That's not true. It's plenty of fun. Maybe I shouldn't say that. Furukawa stops, then starts spinning the broom handle again where she stands. I just gaze at her. All of a sudden, I feel uncomfortable. I feel another me, one that is less attached to the situation, watching us as this takes place. What am I doing? I lose track of time for just a moment. As this happens, Furukawa just looks down at the ground, ever silent. For now, I need to focus on cheering her up. Food! That's right, food! I start thinking of different kinds of food. What is it? What is it that she likes? Big Dango family? Back when the song was popular, every supermarket you walked into had huge packs of Dango made to look like those characters. Furukawa, you like Dango, don't you?
Hi.
Then say the words Big Dango family for me. Use that to cheer yourself up.
Dango 大家族, 売ってますでしょうか?
Probably, but don't worry about that right now. So just say the words and use them as your mantra. Furukawa closes her eyes and then...
Dango 大家族!
She says the words with conviction. So, do you feel more calm?
Hi.
After she opens her eyes, she seems a little bit more positive, relaxed. Like whatever was bothering her loosened its grip a bit. You can tell me what happened later. For now, just go do what you need to do.
Hi.
She grabs the broom in her hands and walks off. The big Dango family seems to have had a miraculously effect on her. I watch her as she fades out of view. That was curious. I wonder what that was all about. But as mentioned, we'll learn later. Later on, Furukawa and I go around posting flyers on billboards around the school. Club recruitment, a full month late. Since the cutoff period for most clubs has already come and gone though, our announcement stands out on its own. Finally, we place a flyer on the last remaining billboard. I stand there and stare at it for a moment, moved. Furukawa's next to me, still a little lethargic. Want to go buy a big Dango family and head home? I move away from the billboard and try to cheer her up. Mind if I ask you something? Just theoretically. Theoretically, if the star didn't have a big Dango family, what would you do? She looks at me, her eyes ready to gush like a near broken dam. Sorry, just messing around. On the way home, we go by two supermarkets. Neither of them have a big Dango family. Furukawa looks like she's on the verge of tears again. I don't know what happened while she was on cleaning duty, but she used the idea of the big Dango family as encouragement to get past whatever was distressing her. So if she can't get one, she'll be back to acting like she was earlier. I have to get one. By any means necessary.
Dango 大家族なんてみんなもう欲しくない。
Furukawa's give up on meter is hitting critically mass, I can tell. Hold on a second. I turn my back to her and dig through my bag. I guess I don't have a choice. Furukawa. I turn back around to her and say her name. She looks utterly heartbroken. You go home. I'll manage to do something about that big Dango family. If I promise, will that make you happy? Okay, then go home and stick out for now. Don't ask another question. It's fine. Just close that trap and head home. She nods, a little uncertain, I can tell, but turns on her heel nonetheless and begins to walk off sluggishly. Don't cry on the way home, either. With those as my parting words, I do a 180 as well. I go back to the supermarket in order to buy them out of Dango. Phew. God, that was heavy. I play the distant supermarket back on the floor, then sit down on it myself. I take the Dango-filled packs out of the bag and break open their seals. What kind of faces did they have again? Oh my god, are you really drawing it yourself? Oh god, and how long are we already in? So, next episode we'll see Tomoya's great artistic adventures. Oh god, this is gonna be... I guess this is gonna be something. So, thank you everybody for watching. Come back for the next episode, and I'll see you then. Bye-bye.